for Disease Control and Prevention say that the country is in the midst of a drug epidemic, and community leaders in La Crosse say Western Wisconsin is no exception. The La Crosse Fire Department says they've responded to more than 200 possible overdoses since 2014.
Today, U.S. Senator Tammy Baldwin visited the Cooley Council on Addictions in La Crosse to host a roundtable discussion on the use of opioids and heroin. WEAU's Aaron O'Brien explains how local stakeholders want to address the issue.
Senator Tammy Baldwin was joined by local first responders, healthcare providers, law enforcement, people all touched by the drug epidemic in different ways and with different ideas on how to fix the issue, but all in agreement that something needs to be done.
I view the opiate and heroin epidemic as a crisis, as an emergency.
I think we'll get there, just take a little more time. The pendulum has swung one way too far, and now we have to bring it back.
Some suggested greater supervision of healthcare providers to make sure they're not over-prescribing painkillers. For example, Baldwin's Jason Simkowski Memorial Opioid Safety Act is making its way through Congress. It aims to strengthen opiate prescribing guidelines at the VA. Others said more resources are needed in the community, including sober living homes to help people recover. One of the big issues brought up today was that of funding. People said that while there's many people in La Crosse that are passionate about making a difference, they still need funding to make that happen. That's why Baldwin is trying to secure emergency funding to improve treatment options in the state. She compared the situation to the Ebola and Zika virus crises that warranted extra funding.
I think we have to look at this as a crisis of equal or even greater proportions that requires an emergency response.
But whatever solution lawmakers pursue, Cooley Council on Addictions Executive Director Cheryl Hancock says that stakeholders need to be able to adapt as the problem evolves.
Addiction is ever evolving. I think that was kind of something that we kept hearing, is that what we know today may change tomorrow, and we have to be flexible in how we're funding those initiatives so that we can respond.
In La Crosse, Aaron O'Brien, WEAU 13 News.
And U.S. Senator Ron Johnson says he instead believes that much of the drug epidemic in the country comes from insecure borders.